my dear friend and longtime co-conspirator Jonas Nash has dubbed First of May. Tell me this, is there one person here in the room who can rightfully describe his or herself as a carny? An inexperienced individual, a newcomer to the circus world, not quite a rube, but not yet a full-fledged zany, a first of May, a debutante into the underground of the circus, whose soul has not yet been overwhelmed by the sawdust and the applause. And it's a strange thing to encounter this day, first of May, here, at this venerable space, that has for so very long been the center of Portland's circus underground. It does me great honor to turn the public address system over to one of the finest bands in the entire alcoholic miscreant underground of Free Cascadia. Ladies, gentlemen, and all the rest of you as well, here's Professor Gall!
Thank you.
watch your drinks as we bring to the stage a gentleman who has for many years proven himself both diligent and dexterous, both studious and stupendous. I mean, of course, that gentleman juggler himself, Mr. Curtis Carlisle. From which we may often drink the skin bottle.
Ah!
star ahead, Miss Brittany Walsh.
It's time, my man. I have some considerable history with this proud venue since it was known as A, the Launchpad Gallery. Since it was first a home for the Bohemian Big Top Underground of Portland, Oregon. And all the way back then, in those hallowed days, even then, before there was a Wanderlust Circus, before there was a William Batty, a group rehearsed and performed here in this very room that has seemed stronger to a genuine institution in the circus great world of this fair city. I refer, of course, to the A-WOL Dance Collective. That you might not miss one exquisite instant of this performance. And Professor Gall, watch your head, old boy, as we are treated to an aerial act by Miss Vanessa Boyd.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Sean Hudson on the bass. Joe Haley on the drum. This is Scott Johnson on the saxophone. And Monty, last minute, Skinner on the trombone.
For how you might entertain yourself. You might want to step outside and have a little cigarette just outside the front door. Or, if your poison is something a little different from tobacco, just carry yourself a little ways further down the block.
Around the block!
You might want to visit our bar, where each and every alcohol purchase will go toward the sustenance of this foul space. You may
unfolding moment. Ladies and gentlemen, a man who holds a PhD in the DTs, Professor Gall!
When we get to the top of the hill, I'll find myself and then lose myself, and then find myself again. But there
it's gonna be
come on.
So how about it, folks? What do you think? It's Professor Gall! And in honor of Professor Gall, I, as you can see, have now begun drinking!
No!
Shame!
So, there is at least one among you who has been present for one of my notorious blackouts.
That's right.
Because that blackout, you can never choose the time, you can never choose the place, but when your name is William Batty, it's always lurking just around the corner.
The interspecies gangbang.
Oh. An interspecies gangbang?
That's right.
Sir, that was not part of my plan for the evening, but somewhere right around here, my plans for the evening will be called off by a devil that lives inside my mind.
Leave it to his species.
Ladies and gentlemen, I will now, once again, introduce to the AFRU Gallery stage a performer who has been long associated with my own beloved Wanderlust Circus. Not to mention, a place where she first received her training and first entered into the Portland Circus Underground, the Circus Project. There's no room for her upon this stage, and so, if everyone will gather in close, you can focus here upon this certified, safety-rated acrobatic bat, which will very, very soon be used to its fullest extent by that fair and flexible femme fatale, Meg Russell.
As an innocent conversation with the tree.
Come on, guys.
A meditation of velocities and scream. Well, they scream at me, but the semi trucks have their say too. And the motorcycles growl. Fade into the night. Ah, ooh, ah. As the modern day enthusiast exudes with delight. Disconnected, stare at those stars as he beams.
come and one more circus performance, but now, while the crowd is at its height, I want once more to remind you all that we are accepting donations, not in our hands, not in our pockets, but in our robot. Yes, that's right, the AFRU bot, located directly next to the water cooler, conveniently close to the bar, just to loosen up those deep, deep pockets and lengthen those short, short arms. If you have a little something to spare for the carnivalesque revolution on this, the day after May Day, you can deposit it right there in the AFRU bot, and you have my personal guarantee it will go directly into the pockets of these hard-working and much-deserving artists, such as these musical artists. Without further ado, or any more talk from yours truly, let's once again hear from Professor Gall! One, two!
Is this a path that we're on? No, it's just a walk. Connected to the soul of each other, disconnected from the half passing on. When the master got us away, the roots have to support that trumpet of pain. Living only for the morning, it's not a day. When no one wants to hear the truth anymore, send us through the heated garages.
Thank you.
title of this very gallery show, as I've already told you, is Carnival Slang for a Newcomer, a First Timer, a Recent Inductee. But does anyone know what else the 1st of May stands for?
Beltane!
How's that? Beltane! Ah, yes, very good. Beltane! A time to let go together as a community. And what else is the 1st of May? Why, it's May Day. It's a revolutionary holiday. Yes, indeed. As I'm told, yesterday was in fact a time of some considerable revolutionary activity in our own downtown Portland, and I was somewhat surprised to discover the same as I made my way through Seattle, Washington. But does anyone here know what I'm referring to when I speak of the carnivalesque revolution?
Universal Workers' Day?
Yes, perhaps. The carnivalesque revolution, first suggested by a gentleman named Mikhail Batty some decades ago. And I have to let you know, my friends, that his suggestion did not go unheeded. That in fact, the revolution is underway. The carnivalesque revolution. A revolution of celebration, of enjoyment, of self-expression that will someday overwhelm the archons of conformity that rule our lives, that will free us all, once and for all, to live within that palace in our minds that has no boundaries. Ladies and gentlemen, the carnivalesque revolution is well underway. We are living in it now. We are standing in its epicenter, here in the unfolding moment. And in the name of the carnivalesque revolution, I am proud to bring out this evening's final circus performer, representing, once again, a Portland institution, the A-WOL Dance Collective, performing to the music of Professor Gall, this sylph of the stratosphere, suspended from the sky upon a single strand of silk. Miss Alyssa Fuchs.
Medicine. Help to breathe, hold, grab it out.
By the local talent of our free Cascadian states.
Yeah!